Yeah, they can. Okay, hello everyone. Today we're gonna be playing. My name is, but I'm not gonna be playing it. My special guest, my cousin Hohe, will be playing it and show you how you guys to do it. Can you give it a tutorial?
Okay.
Your dad play for them. And, okay, so here's Hohe.
Hello. Okay. So this is a quick tutorial on how to play Rise of Nations if you don't know how to play it.
And also you need to be on PC.
I know how to play it.
I was just giving them an example.
Okay. So when you start, you only get to... You cannot play as China, India, or the US. Kinda sad, but I mean, play the game a lot and you'll get to unlock them. Now, normally I like to play as either Germany or Austria. But in this video, we'll be playing as Russia. Because this is a big country and you don't need any. The tutorial, you'll start off with a few troops, if you're a little country, you start off with like 20,000, some 30,000, and some random numbers. Like the UK, you get 160,000. It's just random. So, to start off the game, you want to know about the terrain. Miles, this is the mild winter, this is the Arctic. Semi-mountainous and Arctic. And then this is just arid, which means it's hot there. The jungle is here. And terrain, it's the hilly mountains and like those. Mountainous is this, hilly. Hilly is green, mountainous is red. And semi-mountainous is yellow. Ideologies, you can be fascist, you can be communist. There's two in each ideology, which communist, it's for better factories, and fascist is good for military, and democratic, it's good for your economy. Diplomatic, it shows, I really don't know what this is, I never used it. Faction. Faction, I'll tell you more about that later. Now to start off the game, wait, let me just show one more thing. Resources, have basic resources to start off with. And when is this technology available? You want to click your flag. I'll just teach you about this first. This is how much money you're gaining and how much money you're losing. You lose money because of your upkeep, economic laws. So these things randomly happen. When you put your mouse over it, it's gonna show you lose 30 million or like you lose stuff. You basically want to choose either like something that's better. Like for this, I would personally choose this one. I still lose some of my money, but it's good for stability. Government spending, that's good for like repression. Say I take Estonia, and they're rebelling against me, then I just need to hide. Research spending, it's your research, I'll tell you more about that later. This, it's people with these countries, and B1 country, it's B1. The decisions is where if you get an amount of countries, you get to form one country that's better. Because you get more stability. Ideologies, it's like your ideologies, some are gonna change things, and it's gonna change the stability, because I mean, some people don't like fascists, and some people don't like democracy. It's up to them. These are acts, the Welfare Act, I actually use this, the Neutrality Act, that's a pretty good one, and then whenever you're like advanced research, that's just for random just a random action that are type of modifiers that you get. Let's say, like, it says that you want to build a monument. You get some stuff from that. Like, horse to build. Ranking, structure ranking from now, and number 6. The US is number 1. Of course, number 2. Factions, create a faction, named it something African, alliance, something like that. Volunteer, the song that is clean, you don't fight.
Okay.
Volunteer is basically for, if you want a little bit more than the song, if you don't fight, then just the song. Volunteer, it's if you want to fight a little bit, it's basic, this, fight more, it's pretty more fire. Power using for policies, ideologies, and war policies. War exhaustion, if you go to war too much, you're going to fall apart, if you have some countries. Stability, it's the same thing, it's worse. And you cannot own the economy, trade with other people, and I'll teach you more about the steel and how to make tanks. Aircraft parts is that. Dr. Ryan's in the military. I like to go with mass attack. I like to go with Capital Fleet. Okay, I don't have enough military points, so I'm just not gonna do that. And then I like to use, this is up to you. If you wanna, like, take down airplanes, you go with that. Bombing, it's for bombing the people capital to make the stability die. Ground support, take down the troops, like these. Right there. And then the submarine thing, escort fleets. I really don't, that's frigates and like destroyers, this is submarines, and this is like battleships and aircraft carriers. This, I really don't know what that is, special station. Okay. Now for technology. Technology, I always, you always either need to research the first two. This research improvement, I don't think that does nothing. So just like do that one. And then infantry, always, whenever you have enough, just improve all of these things. So yeah, all of them. That's good. Wait, let's go with this one, okay? There you go. Political, it moves your stability, it's for better for your economy. Support, artillery. Teach you more about the units and stuff. Naval, it's your navy. Aerial, it's your aerial. Planes. And tanks, your tanks. Infantry, basically these guys. The forges, the troops there. And. Okay, now I'm gonna teach you about cities. Cities, you could build buildings. Now, personally, I would like to do fortifications on my capital, but since I'm Russia, it just really doesn't matter. So only if you're like a small country, you need to repress a lot of people. Like, you're at war with France and Germany, you're playing as the UK. If you have a good navy, you're pretty good as the UK. You can help a lot of enemies. And we go back to cities. We'll go to St. Petersburg. Units. When you have enough of the, let's say like supplies, like let's say like steel or something, you can make these. But infantry, you just need manpower and money. Artillery, it's the same thing. See, these things happen where the strikers want demands. Now, I would just accept the demands to be once to lose all this factory output and press the workers, that's not good for stability. So I would just use this, because no, it's not good. So you can be in debt, you can run out of oil, it just does it for every single thing that happens. The destroyers and the frigates, it's the same thing. Just oil, bombers, I don't know. Destroyers and frigates, you can go ahead and show that. Anti-aircraft, same thing, artillery, So, buildings, there's more. I'm just gonna teach you more about this. Aircraft, it's manufacturer. Yeah, okay, I'll build that just to show you guys that. Okay, aircraft manufacturer. And. Oh, I can make steel, man. And we need to get steel. Wait, we can make steel because it's gonna corporate dealing. It could either give you political power or money. I would do that because we don't want money. CD, it's CD stuff to people. And to make a line, oh wait, so start training. I would personally always do this for if I'm gonna make an army because it's pretty good for just if you don't train your infantry or like anything, then you're basically gonna lose any fight. I mean, if you're playing against AI, you still might win. Form a line, I'll teach you that right now. Okay, let's say you're having a cat attack Belarus. I don't know why you would attack Russia as Belarus, but I mean, if that's happening, you gotta make a big line. Hold shift and then click and then do that over here. Hold shift, there you go. Form a line, it's gonna make a line. I always like to just impress people who are in the game, but sometimes this could work against you because they feel threatened because of that. Auto merge if you want to merge all your troops, because why not? And then disband if you're losing a lot of economy, just do that. Auto capture if you're going to war with Poland, this area, it doesn't matter. But if you're going to war with Poland or any country, you just want to click that. It's going to be right here if you declare war. Now, declaring war. Now, we're doing Winter War Part 2. Okay. Now, I went too fast. Go ahead, you go to city. There's city. What is it doing? Click the city. Click their flag. Click, you can declare war, or you can form an alliance. Make puppets day. I don't like to make puppets because you don't get to take their land or anything like that. Justify war goal. You always want to click conquest. I don't know what these are. They never use them though. So I would do that and then click that. Select conquest and then send. Send aid if you want to send aid to someone.
What?
Just do one. It's gonna give that to them. Yeah. This is not a glitch. It just means that they don't. Their manpower is all the way full. I'll teach you about this real quick. Treasury, your money, population, your people, and your country. Manpower is how much manpower you need to like create troops. Troops just shows your aircraft and stuff. And I always miss this, like in the new update, you just gotta scroll down. Fund rebels, it's to fund the rebels, so like if you want them to collapse more, you could do that. View cities, shows Finland cities. Oh. Okay, there you go. Now, you can. Okay, we'll wait for that to happen. Meanwhile, how is the aircraft thing going? How is... Can we make our bombers? Okay, so attacker. Now I want to make attackers for fighting ground units. Bombers for bombing. I usually just
bomb capital cities. It doesn't really bleed out their stability. Fighters fight other planes.
And that's basically it. So I'll make all of these just to show you that it works.
It's actually for that use.
But I mean, I can't test it out with the fighter because I mean, that doesn't work like that.
So now we are at war with Finland. You wanna click declare war and conquest, but I don't wanna do that right now because we're gonna make some tanks. Cause why not? So if you're like a big country, you always start off with some stuff. Like Russia is good for like, I think you start off with like a few stuff for like, wait, where's it? Okay, so you wanna click that. Buildings, it's the, wait, where's the, why does it, where's the steel? Wait, where was my steel coming from? Okay, now we're gonna declare war against Finland. Declare war, conquest, there you go. Now that we have that, we're gonna move to St. Petersburg. Oh, why did I make the fighter first? That is not good. Okay. We're gonna move them there. And now, wait, do we have... Where did I build my steel construction? I don't remember building. Okay, so you just want to click steel construction, and then wait for that to be done. This is a fighter, and I'll show you. You want to click this, it's this the distance of armor. Fine, fight, move it there. It's gonna kill it. See? Yeah, it kills it. Destroys it. Okay, before that happens, we're gonna use our bombers, because I don't want to do that. I'll show you guys how bombers work. Bombers are almost done. Fighters, do they work? I don't think they work with that. Yeah, it doesn't work. That's for like planes. If you want to use like fight against other planes. So this is almost done. So now, I'm gonna teach you about like how you place your troops. So if there's no troops up here, you just want to move some of them to auto capture them. Click auto capture. Now you're moving slowly, so increase your speed. You just want to go to infantry. It's gonna take equipment, or if you want to do more weapons, just go that. I just really need to increase that. See, now they're moving fast. Okay. Now to take out those troops. Is this a bomber? Yeah, that's the bomber. Okay. So now I'm gonna bomb their capital city. And I'll also send a fighter out there. I mean, we're gonna send an attacker out there. And it's gonna follow them forever. Wait, I gotta move this guy. This. There, now they're gonna follow him. Meanwhile, I move my troops to destroy him. And then, meanwhile, I'll have to kill them. So they're moving their troops over here. Meanwhile, I could just destroy everything here. So that's basically most of the tutorial. Now, we're gonna learn about the time it this really doesn't matter. But I mean, just keep an eye on that. So here it just shows you your trade and stuff, your expenses. Just the rest of them. Wait, why is he still alive? I don't really don't know how he's still alive.
That's true.
And meanwhile, all of this is happening, you just wanna use your technology. Meanwhile, you have. Dude, that's gonna really improve all your stuff. Okay, now that we have a ceiling luxury, you just want to click mode. To get these resources like steel, you just want to trade with people who have them. If they don't accept, then beg them. You need those resources. Okay, now we learn about the negotiate terms. So to add more ally, you can just form an alliance is basically what I just showed you guys in the video. Annex, this is what I usually do. I don't know. To make puppets stay, you gotta do it off like the let a country go. I'll show you that soon. Then we're there. Now, to let them go, release countries, release as puppet, I like to do this, if I do this, I do want to release a puppet, I do that, and now, he's a puppet, he can fight for independence, but I mean, who wants to do that, because you're going to lose,
against Russia,
I mean, you can occupy their area, so if they ever start another, fight for the independence, just move your troops into the area. And let's make our tanks right now.
No, motor factory is not done yet. We are almost done.
Meanwhile, just do infantry, economic, to finish like all the basic stuff. Now it is done. Okay, now that you know about that, you want to click tank. Tanks are very good infantry. I mean, it's not infantry, but it's very good ground units. It's good for support, but when I started to play this game, I wanted a lot of tanks, because I thought that was a little bit. Because I was playing it as, let's say, like the Netherlands, and I wanted a lot of tanks, because I thought that was a little bit. So I just built like 2,000 tanks. And then my country went in economic ruin, because I was invading Belgium and Luxembourg. So now that we puppeted Finland, now their tanks are done. Now we're going to attack a big country. Good start of country. Now we will attack. Move all your troops to the area. Oh, if your stability is red, that means you're losing it. Your stability. And whenever you have a puppet, then they're gonna automatically declare a war on them, which is good. More stuff to declare war on, it'll be easier. I mean, if Finland was a real player, I think they would probably help you. Because, I mean, if you switch a server, it's really rare that you're gonna get a country you like. So, I mean, just work for them, and then you'll get probably get paid. But you probably won't at the same time. One is for a
It did happen.
Okay, I'm gonna die too. Wait, don't go on the
edge. So we'll be done live very soon.
Okay. Wait, that was perfect. No, wait. Don't not go in the exit yet. Don't go without your best cousin.
Yeah, I'm open.
There you go. Okay, now.
I'm coming.
Get your warm. Mm-hmm. Wait, is the microphone on? Oh, okay. Okay, I thought the microphone was off. That was very scary. Now, autograph your friend. Yeah, your chests are gonna be instantly broken in them. And this is a, what's that? That's a fighter. Oh no. Move you there. There you go. Let's attack him. No, you there. No. Why did you run out of endurance? No, why are you? Go to him. We need to attack him. Attack him with everything we need. Now that you have almost 50 frames, you get a lot of money for 10 frames. Ukraine is a very good start adventure. Now, auto capture Ukraine. And to make this faster, I want to move all my puppeted countries occupying the area, some of the troops there. And then we took Kiev. So this is the basic tutorial on how to play the game. It's a pretty fun game if you play it correctly. I mean, the rules are, and I'll tell you the rules right now. So let's say you're playing as Germany and you lose to Poland, I don't know why we, and then you become Russia. And then you destroy them with the airplanes and everything. And then you beat them, that's called country swapping. You cannot do that. The researchers think that would happen too. I would always do that. And then... I remember the troops there. And then to let a puppet go, you just want to click this. And then you're in a war together, so just break ties. Click that, and you'll no longer be a puppet. Wait, why does it make puppets say that's weird? And to tell if someone's a puppet, it's gonna have the flag on the top. You know, what's the subject of Russia now, man? We're almost done taking on the Ukraine. Now that you have taken Finland and Ukraine, you just want to take more of like, these lands right here. Because no one really cares about those. And take Europe. These little countries, but if they try, they can take more, just use attacker plane. It's pretty easy to take these little countries. If Germany, invades you, just bomb its capital. Just bomb anyone's capital when you're battlements. Because might as well if you're battlements. Ukraine, annex cities, equip, demand war reparations, and that's it. Now,
we
are home.
Go! Go! Go!
Okay, hold on. There you go. It's done.
Well, guys, thank Johan for a really long video. Well, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.